What's up, guys? Commander Alex here, and today I have a Vainglory Let's Play. So today we're going to be playing as Scarf, and I do have to give you guys some background of this Let's Play before we start. And basically the background that I have to give you is that this was recorded with Chief Matt, who is another great YouTuber. His YouTube channel is called Nothing But Boom, and he plays a lot of Boom Beach on there, obviously, hence the name. He doesn't actually play any of the game that we're playing right now, which is Vainglory, but in the future he might, and you guys should definitely drop him a subscription because he's a great YouTuber and plays a lot of mobile games on there. But moving on with the actual gameplay here, we are going to be playing as Scarf, and he is the new character from Super Evil Mugger Corp. Probably my favorite hero to date, and I really like all the skill shots that Scarf has. So if you guys don't know, all of his abilities are some sort of skill shot. Some of them are more skill shots than others, but they all are non-targeting, and that means that you really just have to shoot where you think it's going to be, and you really just have to be on point when it comes to that sort of thing. So I really like how it works, and I'm definitely loving the character so far. So far, I've been doing pretty well, but this gameplay was definitely one of my best. I had a great one recording with another YouTuber as well, but this one, by far my best. Right here, we're going to go pretty ham sandwich on this guy, and even though Matt got taken out, I was actually able to hopefully at least get him to go away. I thought I might actually be able to pick up a kill there, but I didn't have any of my boots built, and that's probably one of the things that you should build first when you're playing as Scarf, just because boots allow you to have some sort of escape, because Scarf has no actual natural escape, which is very interesting. Anyway, right there, I got a little bit too close to the turret, took a hit, but that's no issue, because I have enough health to sustain through at least a few hits. And now we're going to drop one of those goop clouds right there. I don't really know what to call them, but basically it's just an area full of goop that if you light on fire, it does a bunch of damage. So it's really great. It also does some ignition damage, meaning that you can kind of burst people down by having them on fire and then dropping goop on them. And they can be lit by anything on fire, not just say a fireball or your ultimate. It has to be anything on fire. So that means that even if an enemy is on fire and they walk over a goop pit, they're still going to get lit. So right here, you see I was getting a little bit scared, so I decided to go back to turret, and I was very low on health, but I do have my two Halcyon pots, so as long as I don't get too low, I won't have to use them. But if I start getting very low, obviously I will pop one or two of those. So right here, I thought I actually would have hit one of them with that fireball. Guess I didn't, and now I'm gonna have to run away because I'm very low on health. I also popped that Halcyon pot, and definitely happy about that. I'm gonna keep running right here, and now I'm gonna do something that's great, and that is kiting. So if you guys don't know about this hero, basically he's very, very high in damage, but very, very low in health. He's pretty squishy, but he's a big, big damage dealer. So that means that you want to hide behind enemy character, or rather your own characters. But if you can't do that, then you can do something that a lot of ranged characters do, which is basically kiting. So what you do is you hit him with something, and then you run away a little bit more, and then you hit him with something else, and then you run away a little bit more. And the reason that it works so well with Scarf is, for one, he has a lot of damage to begin with, so that means that it's actually going to be useful, and getting three hits on an enemy might actually do something, rather than, say, you're playing like Petal or something, where you probably aren't actually going to end up doing that much damage. Anyway, the other good point to make is that you can actually get Frostburn, and you're probably going to pick up Frostburn and some sort of other like energy regen. It doesn't really matter what it is, but it just means that you have to have two types of energy regen with this hero, because Scarf really, really relies on that hero, on the hero abilities that he has. But that means that by picking up the Frostburn, you can actually slow your enemies with every shot. And the reason that that works for kiting is that means that you're definitely going to be able to run away, and you're always going to be able to stay ahead, even though you're taking that time to shoot every once in a while. So basically, to sum that up, basically a really good kiting character, and probably one of my favorite in the game at the moment. I also really like Ringo, and I think that this character is pretty similar to Ringo, but probably just a little bit more OP. That's just my opinion, but for me, that's sort of how it's been working. Anyway, right here, we're just going to sit in a lane, pick up a few minion kills. It shouldn't be too hard, and as long as we don't get ganked, we should be doing perfectly fine. I'm going to drop a goop right there. I'm also going to wait for my fireball to recharge. It looks like it's taken quite a while, because I actually only have a energy battery built at the moment. I don't have a void battery, which means that I'm definitely going to be lacking on energy. But right here, we are going to use our passive to actually make that fire burn a little bit quicker on Catherine right there. And the passive with Scarf is that every auto attack you get on someone who's burning actually increases the intensity of that fire, and that means that the fire is actually going to burn a little bit hotter and do a little bit more damage. So it's really cool. Now right here, I have no idea what the heck was going on, but it was an easy kill, so I'm not going to complain about that. And sometimes people just don't really know what they're doing with the controls, and it ends up not working out too well for them. So obviously that was one of the characters right there. Obviously that was a guess, because you can tell by the name He didn't actually have like a real name. He just had guess numbers, numbers, numbers. And that's basically just because I was playing with Chief Matt. And when you are playing in a party, the person who starts the search is actually the person who they base the glory off of. So that means that if you are playing with a very, very low level person, or even a relatively low level person like Matt, and you're a higher level person like me, then you're probably going to end up facing opponents that are easier than you normally would. So that's how I've been getting a lot of my good gameplays. I've been playing with YouTubers who are a little bit not worse than me, but lower level as far as glory goes. And that means that we get matched with easier opponents, and that means that it's easier for me to get some good gameplays. So right there, we got our second kill of the game. We're gonna head into the shop right here and pick up looks like the Frostburn right there. Yep, that's probably the first thing that I'm gonna want to pick up. And then I'll also build some defense later on. Now right there, that was a complete fail. I was trying to tap to move, but instead I tapped to throw a fireball. And it looks like because of that, Chief Matt's actually going to get taken out. So definitely sad on that point, but obviously not too bad. Now right here, I'm gonna use this kiting ability that I was talking about. Just hitting and then running, hitting and then running. And you see Catherine's already down to half health and I haven't taken a hit. So it's definitely useful, and it means that you can stay alive while doing damage, and that's probably the really main goal of the game. Now right here, we're going to use that goop and that fireball to just set some minions on fire. And we're just going to control the lane right here. And as long as we don't lose it, we should be doing perfectly fine. Now, Scarf is obviously a laner. He really likes staying in lane, and he's really not that great outside of lane because the turrets are what he relies on. But you can obviously go down and help out with gold mines and with minion mines if you have to. And you see that obviously every once in a while I'll head down into the jungle and help out a struggling teammate. But for the most part, you're going to want to stay in the lane. Now, anyway, we're just going to take out these minions right here. And as long as we can push far enough, we should be able to take this turret or at least do a ton of damage to it, because there's two of us, a few minions, and no enemies around. Looks like the enemy's minions are going to spawn though, so we're going to have to drop a goop. And I was actually not really planning right there because I don't have enough energy to set my fireball to actually light it, and I had to wait quite a while. But it looks like eventually I did get enough energy, and I'm going to be able to light that goop and take out the remaining enemy minions. Now, the enemy hero actually walked over to us, so that was a little bit dangerous. And then Cruel walked over to us, and things got even more dangerous. But I got under turret quick enough, and I actually managed to stay alive. So definitely good there. It looks like Chief Matt's also going to jump out. And obviously that's why I liked staying in lane with Scarf, just because that means that you have somewhere to escape to if you're getting completely destroyed. Now right here, just looking at the score, we're doing pretty well. I'm 2-0, and it looks like all my teammates are fairly positive, or at least even. And we're going to pick up just some regular defense right there. Just the first tier, nothing too crazy. Looks like Catherine decided to dive really deep into our territory. No idea what that was about, but that was a great kill by Matt. And obviously, if you can draw an enemy under a turret, then obviously that's going to be a big advantage for you in any fight. Now, right here, for some reason, Cruel was charging way too deep into our jungle, and we're gonna have to punish him for that. So I'm going to just send a fireball right there to hopefully set him on fire. It looks like I'm also going to drop a goop, and now I'm gonna use my ultimate, which is going to wreck shop. Oh my god, that was just great. And as long as you stay alive to charge up your ultimate, it's probably one of the most useful things in the game at the moment, just because it does splash damage, so you can take out multiple enemies at once, and it's just a ton of damage whenever it hits somebody. So a really, really great ability, and probably my favorite at the moment. But it does mean that you have to either stay outside of the fight for a little while to charge it up, or you have to do it at an opportune location so that you don't get hit from behind or just completely destroyed before you can use it. Also, if you're playing as Cruel, this is just a little bit of a note here. If you're playing as Cruel, then you can use your ultimate to cancel the ultimate of Scarf. So it's something that people don't really know about, but if you actually use a stun, you can cancel a lot of the really, really strong ultimates in the game, and it's something that's very useful. So right here, we were just messing around with them. I was actually pretty low on health, but for some reason, we ended up winning that fight right there. They're both gonna walk away with lower health than me, and I'm just gonna chase them right back into their turret. Now, we obviously are winning lane at this point, and as long as nothing screws up in the jungle, we should be doing pretty well. I'm gonna drop a fireball right there just to do some damage to the turret, and our fireball is now max, which means that it's going to have quite a bit of damage. And since we have the Frostburn, we're actually going to be able to use it to get away from enemies. Now, right here, I was pretty much dead right there. If Cruel had charged me, then he would have taken me out, but for some reason he didn't, and I walked away with 5 kills and 0 deaths. No idea what that was about, but as long as they don't charge me like that, I'm perfectly fine with it, and that's the exact reason why I want to stay in lane. So I'm just looking at the score right now. We're 7-7, doing pretty well. It looks like some of the other characters on the team aren't doing quite as well, but we're going to do perfectly fine. Picking up the second tier armor and shield right there, and that's just going to mean that we don't get powered down quite so easily, and it's really, really something that you're going to want to build if there's a Taka on the enemy team. Now, obviously, there isn't in this game, but I have had games where Takas have been on the other team, and they are definitely the worst thing when you're a Scarf, just because they have so much burst damage, and they can go invisible. It's almost impossible to find them, and they take you out so quickly, you barely get to use any of your abilities. So, probably one of the biggest issues when it comes to pretty much any hero, but definitely a great hero to use if you're trying to counter Scarf. Now right here, we're just going to sit her in the lane, get some gold as well as push these minions in, because we do want to take that first turret just to give us some extra control over the jungle, and that means that they're probably going to stop ganking me from that bush. As long as we can take out this turret, they'll probably stop doing it, but it looks like Krul is actually going to come out of nowhere and take out Matt right there. That was a little bit disappointing, but we're going to kite him away, and we're going to walk away with pretty good health. It looks like there are two of them now, so that's a little bit dangerous, and we're going to upgrade our ultimate, and as long as we can stay alive here, we should be able to help out Catherine and do some good damage to this Krul. So I'm going to drop my goop right there, waiting for my fireball to spool up, and it looks like there it is. We're going to set Krul on fire. He's going to run away, and now we're going to have control of the lane with 6 kills and 0 deaths. Looks like the next enemy to try and take us on is going to be Glaive. He's a pretty good character. I really like playing him, but I don't think that he's actually as good as a lot of the more advanced characters like Scarf, like Krul, like some of them. I think that they're definitely better characters. But right here, we're just going to chase him away again. Not really getting a lot of kills when it comes to that sort of stuff, but we're definitely powering down the enemies to get them low on health and making them scared of us. And that's obviously what you want to do when playing any hero. So right here, we're just going to sit in the lane, take some gold, take some minions out, and this should definitely be our final push, because even if they come and try and attack us, we should be able to take it out no problem. I'm going to drop my goop and then fireball, and that's a really, really nice thing that you can do if you think that you're not going to be able to take out a turret, but you can have enough energy to drop those two things. You can actually drop the goop right under the turret and then light it with fire, and that's going to do damage to the turret over time, and there's no way that the enemy can cancel that. So even if you die, even if something crazy happens, then it's still going to do that damage, and if the turret's low enough, it might actually take it out without you even being there. Now right here, that was a really, really easy kill. Probably shouldn't have even been mine, but it was a kill for us, and that's going to make us 7-0. We're still in the fight, though. We're going to be trying to take out this Glaive right here. It looks like we're going to set him on fire, and that's going to be our 8th kill of the game. Looking at the map right here, I'm not quite sure where we want to go. It looks like they're pinging the minion mine, and instead of doing that, I'm actually going to head over into the shop, because there's two of them there, or rather one of them there, and that minion mine shouldn't be too hard to take out. Now, we are going to build some speed right here. We're going to go straight to those journey boots, and the journey boots are probably one of the things I should have built a little bit earlier. But that's all right, because we are still going to be able to build them now. And once we have the journey boots, we have a great escape. Now, obviously, Scarf has no natural escape, but with the journey boots, you get a pretty good escape. And having that speed is great for positioning, because obviously Scarf relies on those skill shots, which rely on positioning a lot. Now, right here, we're going to kite away that Krul. Thought that he was actually just going to get stunned by Catherine, but it looks like that's not going to happen. Instead, Catherine is going to get turned on, and we're going to have to help him out right here. So I'm just going to sit here, keep doing some damage. I'll throw in that fireball, and that's going to get Krul very low on health. He's going to have to back out of the fight. Looks like Catherine and Glaive are coming at us, but the turret's going to help me out, and I'm going to be able to push them right back out into the lane, and we're going to keep the fight going. All right, so looking at the battle right now, it looks like we can drop a fireball right there just to make sure that Glaive doesn't want to fight us anymore. We are so full on health, and all the enemies are losing health rapidly. So we're just going to sit in lane right here, and I was actually looking for a kill, so I'm going to charge pretty far ahead and see if we can pick someone up in the bush. Looks like Krul is down on the bottom right over there trying to take that minion mine. Also, Catherine is right here. I tried to hit her with that fireball, but that wasn't going to happen. Now right here, I was really hoping that I could do something, but all I could do was actually drop that goop, and that only slowed them. It didn't actually do any damage to them, and that meant that Catherine was in some pretty hot water. Now right here, I'm going to get in some hot water on my own, but it looks like Catherine is going to be too scared of me to try and take me out, and she's actually going to get taken out by, she's not going to get taken out, but she's going to get scared away by my fireball. Anyway, we're going to continue the fight here. It looks like Krul is trying to do some damage to us, but he's going to get pushed away right back into their turret, and now we have him pushed pretty far away in lane, and obviously they're not going to be trying to go to jungle, because we can take turret quite easily if they're not here. So we're just going to sit right here. I'm going to throw my fireball at him, and the passive is going to do its work and take out that Krul no problem right there. Looks like he's going to give us 195 gold, and now it's going to be 2v1. We are down on heroes at the moment, but it looks like Catherine, I almost called him Krul, Catherine's going to come and help us out, and she is going to try and take out the enemy Catherine while we take out this glaive. So it looks like both of them are going to go down, or at least get very low on health. Then the glaive is going to go down, and now we're going to have to try and focus down at that Catherine. So right here, I'm just going to push right past all my minions, and I was actually trying to throw that fireball right at Catherine, and I was very, very close, but I guess not quite close enough, because we're not going to get that flame damage, and we're not going to be able to take out Catherine. So we're going to have to settle with 9 kills, 0 deaths, and we can march down here to the minion mine and get ourselves a little bit more of a minion boost when it comes to damage and health. So we'll just hop into lane right here. Looks like before that happens, though, Cruel is going to try and do some damage to us. And we're not really scared of him at this point because we have some pretty good defense built. And obviously, there's 3 of us here. So instead, we're just going to fight him. And now we're just going to be targeting down whoever is in front of me. Don't really know who I'm hitting, so I can't really use my passive all that well because I don't know who's on fire. But it doesn't matter because we're going to get a nice easy kill off of Cruel right there. And now it's going to be focusing down Catherine. So it looks like Glaive was actually behind us. So instead of turning to try and take Catherine, we're going to try and take out Glaive right here, and it should be pretty easy because there's 2 of us and Glaive is fairly slow, so I can keep cutting him away. And it looks like right here we're going to get a nice easy kill, or at least assist, and that's going to be pretty much all the kills that we can get right now because the enemy is basically aced. I believe that there is still 1 enemy up, but that's not too much of an issue because obviously there's 3 of us up and only 1 of him. So moving on with the video right here, looks like we're going to take out that monster, no problem. 2 of us versus 1 monster is not going to be an issue. We are up on kills, but not by that much, and the game's definitely still pretty tight as far as kills go. And we're actually going to take out this minion mine just to make sure that our lane is definitely on par with theirs. And then we're going to head over here and basically just run away from this Catherine because we do not want to get taken out at this point. A flawless game is something you don't see every day and you don't want to ruin it. So we're just going to throw that fireball at her, and now we're going to come in with my teammates to just completely annihilate this Cruel. It looks like Catherine is getting bombarded by all of them, and it's not going to go too well for her, but we are going to be able to take out this Cruel right here. It looks like we're actually going to throw a final fireball to push him away, and then we're going to have to run away because there's 3 of us very low on health, and then there's 3 of them very high on health. So I'm just going to keep throwing some fireballs whenever I can, and I'm actually going to back in this bush over here so that I don't get taken out. Looks like Catherine's going to try and come after me, but she's not going to see me, and I'm going to get home safe and sound. So that's going to be, it looks like 10 kills, 0 deaths for us. We have broken that 10 mark, and now I am the only one alive. Things are getting pretty dangerous, and I have a flawless game, but I do have a commitment to my teammates to try and save this Kraken. So I'm just going to head over here. I'm going to check this bush first, or at least I should have checked this bush first because there were 3 of them there, and that was something that I was not ready for. But I am going to be able to kite away this Catherine very easily. Looks like I'm actually going to check the bush this time. I'll wait for my fireball, send it right there. Looks like I'm actually going to hit someone. That's going to be, who is that? That's Cruel that I hit right there. And now I'm going to have to run back to my turret right there. But now I have Chief Matt with me. We're going to head into this jungle right here. It looks like I'm going to use my ultimate, and awesomeness is going to ensue. We're just going to completely power down that Cruel right there, get him very low on health, and now we're going to throw everything we've got at him to take him out. Now, I am also very low on health, and this could get dangerous very quickly, but I'm going to keep throwing some fireballs, and it looks like the flame actually managed to take out Cruel. So, great kill right there, and we're going to have to circle back around to help out my teammates, who are doing pretty well on their own over there. So, we're just going to head over here, 11 and 0, throw that fireball. Looks like when Catherine is in her little like sprinting position like that, you can't actually hit her with a fireball. Don't know if that's actually a glitch or if that's just like how the ability works, but either way, it's pretty cool, and obviously it was something I wasn't ready for, but we are going to get a nice little hit on the fireball right there, and that's going to give us a kill, or rather give Catherine a kill and give us the ace on the enemy team. So we're just going to take out some of these monsters over here, and then we'll head back for the Kraken. So it looks like we're doing pretty well. Just looking at how long, hopefully I'll look pretty soon, because obviously whenever you're taking the Kraken, you want to check how long the enemy team has to respawn. It looks like one of them has already respawned. The other 2 have about 10 seconds to go. So we want to be very quick about this, and I'm probably going to end up using my ultimate just to make sure that we secure it. So I'm just going to continue to stay in the bush over here, and once the Kraken gets fairly high on capturing, I'm going to pop my ability, my ultimate, and I'm actually going to try and just power him down to make sure that the enemy doesn't get to steal him. And that's exactly what I did right there. Took that Kraken Kraken, no problem. Looks like the enemy was too scared to try and take us out. And now I'm going to, I thought I was actually going to upgrade my coat of plates, but I decided not to. Instead, I decided to get some gold from the enemy mine, I was almost going to call them miners over here, from the enemy monsters over there. And that's going to give us almost 300 gold, or rather almost 1,300 gold. Anyway, we're going to walk over here. It looks like Matt's getting empowered down by two enemies, so we're definitely going to want to help him out. We're going to head over here, drop our fireball. Wow, I'm getting tongue-tied, guys. Drop a fireball over there, and that's going to do some damage. We're also going to head over here and try and take out this Glaive, who is going to run away, and I'm actually going to check the bush just to be safe. But before I do that, Matt's going to be right back in the fight, so we got to help him out. We're going to throw some fireballs, and while Matt did get taken out, that did give the Kraken quite a bit of time on turret, and that means that we're going to take that turret very soon right here. So continuing on with the video, just want to pester them right here. I'm going to continue to just annoy them and make sure that they don't target down the Kraken, because as long as we can continue to annoy them, we're going to be able to continue to basically just allow that Kraken to do damage. So I'm just going to pull them all the way out here. I have no idea why they chased me so far, because the Kraken just took a turret, and they only have Cruel working on the Kraken at the moment. So we're just going to go throw that fireball right there. I thought that actually would have hit Catherine, but I guess it didn't, and we're going to have to continue to try and take her out. Threw a fireball right there, just checking to see if someone was in the bush. It's a great way to check bushes. If you guys didn't know, you can throw a fireball right in there, and anyone in the bush is actually going to be revealed if they are hit. Anyway, we're going to sit around here. It looks like we're at 1,800 and about 50 gold, so we're going to have to head over here to the shop, and then we'll head over there and try and take out the final few turrets. Don't know why someone was pinging it, because at the moment, there's really no way that we can take out those two turrets, but definitely in the future, we're going to be trying to head for those, and I don't know if we'll even have to get the next Kraken to do that. So right here, we're just going to completely annihilate those two monsters right there, get some extra gold for ourselves. Looks like Matt is getting destroyed right there, so we're going to have to help him out. We're going to pop our ultimate and actually end up hitting all two of those teammates right there. We're also going to throw in our fireball, and now we're just going to be focusing down and getting those passive hits on Cruel right there, just because the more passive hits I get on him, the more damage that fireball does, or rather the flame does on him. Now right here, we were actually going 2v2, and Catherine was very low, so I was pretty dangerous, and I actually wasn't sure if we were going to win this, but it looks like Catherine is going to get taken out, and at this point, I'm the only person left, and there's two of them, so I'm going to have to be very sneaky about this, and this is where that kiting comes in handy. So you see, I popped my shield right there, and now I'm going to use my fireball right there just to, or in a second, right there, just to do some damage and to slow down that Catherine. Looks like they're still chasing me, and we're just going to continue to run around the map here and just continue to destroy them and annoy them. Also, I have the the boots that I have right now are just going to allow me to have that extra speed and make sure that I am able to take them out. It looks like right here, I'm actually going to get a kill. Even though I am going 1v2, I managed to get a kill. It looks like Glaive decided to try and take out this minion miner over here, but we can definitely take him out. We're going to throw a fireball at him, then get some passive hits on him to make sure that fireball does more and more damage. And now things are going to get very dangerous for him. He's very low on health. He's going to try and turn to get away, but he doesn't do it. He's going to go down for 195 gold for us and the 13th kill of the game. Looking at what we can build right here, I'm going to build a void battery so that I can continue to get extra energy, because obviously if I run out of energy, I'm pretty much useless. It's true. Once I run out of energy, I'm useless as a character. I really don't think that there's much that this character can do if he doesn't have energy, but when you do have energy, you are a complete boss. So I definitely want to build that energy regen and make sure that we never run out. Anyway, we're going to hop over here into lane, seeing if we can take out this Cruel. Looks like I'm just going to pester him for a while. I'll drop my goop pretty soon just to make sure that he doesn't try and take me out. I'm actually going to drop it on the minions right there just to make sure that we can push these minions in and start doing some damage to their turret. Looks like we're actually being targeted down by two enemies at the moment, and things are going to get a little bit dicey right here. So we're going to have to use both of our abilities right there, or rather just our boots. No, we used both of our abilities just to get away from them right there. And now it looks like Catherine's going to come here, help us out. She's going to throw down her deadly science, I believe it's called, or something along those lines. And basically, it just silences the enemy's abilities so they can't use them. But we are going to pick up a kill right there from Catherine. That's going to mean that we are going 2v1 on this Cruel, and that's a bad thing for him. So we're just going to continue to peck away at him. He has some boots built, so he's going to be fairly quick. But as long as we can get a hit on him, we're actually going to have our Frostburn do some work and slow him down for a little while. Now, right here, he's at I'm about maybe one third health. We're going to throw another fireball. It looks like I didn't hit him, but this turret is already down. So we're going to end up picking up the assist right there. And that's going to be our 14th kill of the game. Looking at what we have left, though, there's only two turrets. So we might just end up pushing straight into the enemy's base and trying to take those. We do only have three minions at the moment, so definitely not going to try and do too much damage to them. But that one turret is very low in health, so we're definitely going to be trying to focus down that one first, and then we'll be moving on to the next turret. Now, looking at kills, we are definitely up now. We are up by four kills. Obviously, not as many as we'd like to be, but more than we probably should at this point. Anyway, we took out that turret, no problem. Moving on to this next turret, we're going to throw a fireball at it just to do some damage, and definitely just trying to make sure that we auto-attack and get a bunch of damage done on that turret. Now, right down here, it looks like the minion mine is actually going to be able to be taken by Chief Matt, and the reason why I got out of the enemy's base was because I saw that they had actually just had a hero spawn, and I didn't want to get caught out while inside of their base, because once you get caught out inside of an enemy's base, it's pretty much easy for them to close the entrance, or rather the exit, and not allow you out. Now, right here, didn't know what the heck Crow was doing, or rather Glaive. He actually decided to just sit there. I'm going to throw a fireball, completely horrible aim, and I'm not going to get the frostburn on him, which means I can't chase him down. Instead, I'm going to have to come back down here to the shop, and I'll pick up the Eve of Harvest, which is going to give me some great lifesteal, and that's just more when it comes to... Basically, when it comes to kiting people away, if I can get lifesteal, then that means that even if I'm low on health, through kiting, I can get a lot of health back. Now, right here, I'm going to use my ultimate and just completely annihilate that Glaive, take him down to practically no health. Thought that fireball might actually finish him, but instead, he's going to get away right here, and we're going to have to use a fireball right there to try and take him out. Looks like we're not going to take him out. Instead, we're going to have to deal with this Krull right here. He's doing quite a bit of damage, but it's used almost all of his abilities at this point. So I'm doing fairly well in health, and instead, I'm going to throw a fireball at him just to do some damage, get some passive stacks on him right there, and things are going to get pretty dangerous for him. Now he's about as low as I am, and you can see those numbers right there. That's where he is, and that's an easy way to tell where an enemy is. If they have damage being done to them, they're actually going to have those numbers showing up, whether they're in a bush or not, and that's a great way to basically always follow an enemy around, even if you don't know exactly where they are. Anyway, we took out that enemy hero, no problem. We're going to pick up that eclipse right there, and now it's going to be finishing the game. I don't even think we need the Kraken. We're just going to end up pushing straight through this enemy's base and hopefully take in that vein crystal. So right here, we're just going to drop a goop, set that on fire, and push these minions in right through the enemy's base. It looks like there's only two of them, so it's going to take us a while to try and take out this turret. But obviously, I can use that goop trick with the fireball to do some extra damage. Now, right there, I thought that fireball was actually going to end up hitting Catherine, but instead it didn't. So I have to use my ultimate right here, and I was stuck behind an enemy turret, which was kind of annoying. But that's all right, because we're going to be taking on the enemy 2v2 right here. It looks like Catherine's already very low, so I'm going to be targeting her down, and our Catherine actually got taken out first. So instead, we're going to have to go after their Glaive, and it looks like Glaive is going to go down eventually right there for an assist, and now we're going to have to head after the enemy's heroes. But before we do that, we do want to take out these minions right here, just because as long as we take out the minions, that means that the turret's going to be distracted, and we can head in a little bit closer to try and attack them. Now, right here, Chief Matt was getting caught out pretty badly, so I wanted to help him out. I threw a fireball just to slow Krull right there, and now I'm going to basically just sit right in front of them, annoy them, and hopefully they're going to target me rather than Chief Matt. Chief Matt obviously is getting away at this point, and I don't really have to worry about that, but now I have to worry about myself, and I actually got silenced, which means I can't use my abilities. Definitely a dangerous thing when it comes to Scarf. And at this point, I can't use my ability, so we're going to have to head back to see if we can take them out. I'm going to drop my goop right there, and then I'm going to basically just run away because that goop is a great slowing tool. I'll also drop a fireball behind me to slow down that Krull, and now it's just going to be basically annoying them and then getting back to turret. So right here, we are at turret. We're going to drop a fireball right on that Krull just to annoy him a little bit more. Head over here and try and take out this guest. Going to throw that fireball. I didn't actually think that was going to connect, but it did. So that's some great damage. And again, just sort of kiting them away and making sure that they're annoyed and never have that much health. So we're going to throw a fireball at that Catherine right there that did connect. We're now going to get targeted down by this Krull. And I was pretty scared at this point, so I popped my boots just to get away. And now that I'm away, I can actually head back in and try and take out some of the enemy heroes right here. Looks like we're almost going to get the kill on that Catherine. Oh, just so close. And I'm actually getting targeted down by, it looks like Krull at this point. So pretty dangerous right there. And obviously, I'm going to want to try and get out of this. So I'm just going to keep running away. And I'm going to be using my flaming balls. I did have to say that. I'm going to be using my flaming balls to basically just kite away the enemy. I'm also going to be using that goop right there to slow them down and make sure that they can't follow me quite as closely. It looks like Glaive is the only one that's really following me at this point, and he is a man on a mission trying to take me out right here, and he's staying with me pretty well even though I'm cutting him down. But for every hit that I get and all that damage, I'm actually gaining health. So I'm going to sit in this bush right here. He has no idea where I am. He's actually going to head right into the lane right there. Don't know why he decided to do that, but my team is now right behind me, and we're going to be able to focus him down right here. So we're just going to completely annihilate him. Definitely made him a little bit confused right there, and I'm definitely happy with how that turned out. So that's going to be, or I guess that'll just be an assist for us, but that is 15 kills for us in the game, and things are going to go pretty well. Looking at what we can buy, there's not much. We do have the H regen though, so we're going to have to take out this Kraken, and we should be able to finish the game on this push right here. So we're just going to pull him into the jungle right here, and then we're going to pop the ultimate fairly soon. Don't know when that's going to happen, but obviously I want to pop that just to make sure that we take out this Kraken as soon as possible and get him on his long, long walk to the enemy's Vayne Crystal. Now looking at the map right here, it looks like they have Catherine up, but we don't really have to worry about that because there's three of us and one of her, and things should be going pretty easily. So we're just going to walk straight past all of these monsters and then in the jungle, and we're going to head right into their base. I am going to drop that right there. I have no idea why I decided to drop a goop, but it doesn't matter because we're going to just sit over here in their base and basically just pester them and make sure that none of them get out, and that's going to make sure that all of my teammates can farm and don't have to worry about possibly being powered down. Now right here, we're just going to continue to kite them away right here. Looks like I'm getting 2v1'd right there, so I really don't want to do that. I'm just going to run away right here. I'll throw a flaming ball behind me just to make sure that I don't get chased too badly. And now we're going to be able to take out that Catherine right there. And gotta love that flame damage. We're gonna head right back into their base right here, and now we're gonna be focusing down this final turret right here. Looks like we're gonna be able to take that out no problem, and now we're gonna be taking out this Glaive right there. That's gonna be our 17th kill of the game, and I think that is going to be game, guys. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscription, and become a lieutenant today. I'll talk to you guys next time, and yeah, become a lieutenant today.